questions I get from individuals and the officers I deal with on a daily basis is much different than what I would get outside the hospital in regular clothes. And my fear and some mild inherent distrust of law enforcement, that goes back to my own personal experiences that I've had over my entire life, as well as hearing the stories from friends and family that look like me that have had similar experiences. I don't understand why people think it's okay to kill police officers. I don't understand why black men die in custody and they're forgotten the next day. I don't know why this has to be us against them.
What you want, but right. We've all been socialized to believe certain things about certain people. And that just needs to stop.
And whether you even know it yourself, there could be a subconscious level of racism or prejudice within
individuals. There's
implicit
bias, there's outward bias, there's all kinds of biases that
that's also influencing your perceptions and then ultimately the actions you take when you encounter people.
Absolutely. And now, having said that, what I try to also advocate to people is that when we have these incidents, these police-related incidents, like the shooting in Baton Rouge, like the shooting in Minnesota, I always advocate to people try to just take a step back, let the facts and circumstances and the evidence come out before weighing in fully to determine what happened there. Just, you know, instead of playing Monday morning quarterback and just, you know, side sealing and delivering the cops, you know, based on very little, if any, information. So that's absolutely critical. Once all that information has come out, if it's found that these cops acted in a biased or racist way, then you won't find anyone in law enforcement who have a problem with them being fired, jailed, sued, and otherwise, because there is no room for that.
Well, you look at Ferguson,
business.
For example, because that's one of the incidents that have caught so much attention and so much fire with the protesters in particular, and we do know that, you know, there was an indictment of Darren Wilson, the officer involved in that particular case, and he was cleared. But the Department of Justice did find, in their investigation, racism all throughout that police department. And so you look at those types of investigation results, you looked at some of the statistics and studies that show black people are more likely to be touched, handcuffed, pushed to the ground, and pepper sprayed by a police officer, according to a recent Harvard study, than their white counterparts. So there is factual proof that this is happening. Laura, President Obama is going to Dallas today. Here he is, the nation's first African